best thing I've ever done. Absolutely without a doubt. The rush that came afterwards. I think I nearly blacked out. Maybe I even did for a second. A nanosecond.
So Cherry is a monologue by a single actress about popping her cherry. So it's about her first time. And then there's a twist on that come about halfway through. And then we explore a little bit more about the fact that she's this fantasist and all is not as it seems, you know. So it's popping her cherry, but it's her first time doing something else rather than what you think it might be. Well, so, I mean, it's written by the actress that performs it, the film, a local actress called Jalita Galbraith. So she came to me early last year with this monologue that she'd written and wanted basically just to film it. It was a long monologue. So I just kind of explained to her that I see a lot of monologues because obviously actors and actresses send monologues in as part of their show reels or as part of their audition process. And they're boring because they're long, they're just in front of a black screen. You'll watch 30 seconds of it and you've switched off. So it's just like, if we're going to do it and we're going to film it, let's try and add some style to it. Let's try and have some fun with it. So at least when you are sending this monologue off to auditions, whatever, it will stand out a little bit, you know? And there was just a lot of story in her monologue anyway.
But then one day you realize you have no doubts and the other person is giving you all the right signals and you say to yourself, this is it. And that's how it was for us.
We're lucky living in Bristol, man. It's a little London. You can get things done in Bristol. There are crew everywhere, selfless people just want to get stuff made. Like I said, Cherry had a budget of 300 quid. Do you know what I mean? But we had a full pro crew. We shot on, you know, the best cameras, whatever, because people in Bristol are willing to get involved because they want to see the community thrive. And that's why, you know, this festival, Bristol needs it, because this is a festival for filmmakers and not a festival for the hierarchy or a festival for, you know, selling pretentious wares or art house, you know, look how cool we are. This is every film in there deserves to be there on the merit of the film, nothing else. Not the logos at the end of the film, not the sponsors behind the film, not the budget of the film. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, on the actual enjoyment
of that film. Is it good enough to get in? Yes, it is. And I want to screen it. I want to give it an audience. And that's what Bristol needs. That's what the film industry in general needs. But Bristol especially, because obviously we've got Encounters, different kind of festival. This is more filmmaker focused, and that's what the industry needs. But yeah, Bristol's amazing. Yeah, I love Bristol. The last one we just shot, went to the BFI with a script and asked for 15 grand. That's the top of their budget. Jumped through all the hoops. They said it's too ambitious, right? And fair enough. By the book, it probably is too ambitious. But you get out in Bristol, you can make a 15 grand film for a lot less because there's talent here. There's a willingness to get involved and get stuff made. The industry in Bristol is amazing.
Yeah. Would you recommend students go outside of the university and talk to the community to try and get involved themselves?
I might be saying controversial stuff here, but like, student films all look, feel, and play like student films. I just think if you let these students off the leash a little bit and get out there, you can be brave as well. Yeah. Like, don't be boxed in by, I never went to university, I never went to college, I never went to secondary school art, you know what I mean? Yeah. I think film in general, all art, you have to be brave. All right, this is what it is. Say you're a student at uni, right?
Yeah.
And you have to make these in-house films. Be brave enough to go, yeah, but there's no DOP here at this uni that I feel comfortable enough or is good enough to make my vision a reality. That DOP over there, I want to go and engage with him and go, hey, I'm a student, I have no money, but if I use you, my film's going to look legit. Do you fancy it? Here's the script. Do you know what I mean? Because sometimes it can be too late, because you get these students and you box them in. They've made four or five student films, rubbish. And then they're using that as their showreel to get more work once they leave university. Whereas if their second film, you went, actually, go out there and spread your wings and make films with people that are better than you, higher qualified than you, been doing it more than you. I make a point of every time I make a film, get people around you that are better than you, man. They know more than you. Be the person in the room that be the least qualified in the room. I like to be.
I learn from it.
Like, so I don't know nothing about cameras. I'm not a camera guy. I'm not a technical guy. So I'll get someone that knows everything about cameras, and that's their passion. My passion story.
Yes.
So if I got someone that their passion is technical stuff, it's a match made in heaven, isn't it? Because Whereas another mistake I think people make is they try doing too much of themselves because they feel like they have to. I'm a filmmaker. It means I have to know a bit about sound, or I have to know a bit about cameras, I have to know a bit about editing, I have to know a bit about grip. Not really, I don't think. I don't think that's the case at all. I think all you need is passion and a good story.
I couldn't believe I had finally done what I'd been thinking about, obsessing about really, for so long.